I wanna show all of my haters love. This song's for you. If you had it like me and I was in your shoes, I'd probably hate on me too. See, when you're getting big cash backs, all the haters hate that, cause they hate to see you be successful. I wanna show all of my haters love. So I wave to you like good morning. Hey, hey, hey.
Day, I'm feeling like I'm Ice Cube. I'm waking up like can't nobody mess up my mood. Knowing I'm a boss, I'ma do what I choose. If I was you, then I would probably hate on me too. If it's true, then money is time, then watch this. Ain't trying to run out of time, so I purchased some watches. Y'all sick, the chips got the haters not shits. They chicks jumping in my whip.
Get the cash. All of my haters love. This song's for you. If you had it like me and I was in your shoes, I'd probably hate on me too. See, when you're getting big cash stacks, all the haters hate that, cause they hate to see you be successful. I wanna show all of my haters love. So I wave to you like good morning. Hey, hey, hey.
Good morning, Eagles. Today is Tuesday, April 16th, and we are back with another great episode for Season 12, Episode 116 of Eagle News. My name is Charlotte. Happy National Rubber Eraser Day.
And my name is Maya. Now let's go meet our studio host.
My name is Amelia.
And my name is Gavin.
And here are today's headlines.
All girls that would like to try out for Hyatts Cheer, there are cheer clinics today at 3 to 5 in the cafe, as well as tomorrow at the same time.
There is English state testing tomorrow and Thursday from 8:15 to 10 a.m., so make sure you are quiet as you walk through the halls and get a good night's rest and eat a big breakfast.
Let's celebrate diversity at Hyatts. We are looking for participants interested in showcasing what makes your family unique. Ideas include your ethnicity or culture, an interesting career, different language, culture cuisine/sampling of foods, culture, dance, and traditions, information about learning abilities, differences, the ideas are endless. To reserve a station at a free event, please contact Mrs. Waltz.
Hyatts Film Festival. Filmmakers, don't forget that your films are due on April 22nd. That's 6 days, okay?
6 days.
Turn it in. Mr. Mata would like all filmmakers to check in with him on your progress of your film.
This Friday, April 19th, there will be no school.
Woo!
Yay!
Enjoy your day off.
Enjoy your day off, yes.
Also, don't forget to check out the Eagles Beak podcast on the podcast app. Mr. Mata and Eagle News will be selling caramel. Wait. That's you.
Mr. Mehta and the Eagle News crew will be selling caramel chocolate bars, even better, after school. Each candy bar is $1. What a steal. Buy one on your way to the bus. Proceeds go to the Hyatts Film Festival.
Liberty T-shirts. Students, don't forget to turn in your Liberty T-shirt order forms to the office. They're all due this Thursday, April 18th.
Thank you, Amelia and Gavin. Now it's time for our daily trivia.
Please remember to text Mr. Mehta with your answer, and we will announce winners at the end of the news.
The first clue is for 10 points, and all of your answers will be worth 10 points until we give you the next question. Here's the first clue.
A group of them is called an army. Again, a group of them is called an army.
Send your answers to Mr. Mehta if you want your 10 points.
Time for birthdays. The people celebrating birthdays today are Jason B.
and Brianna S.
Happy birthday!
Woo! Yeah!
Birthdays
are awesome.
Today we have a Hyatts tea video by Cameron and Cammie.
What exactly? Wait a second. Who just did that? Was that you? Was that you, Char?
Do what? Just say
read
that?
Yeah,
I did.
What exactly is Hyatts tea?
It's from Great Britain.
It's like drama.
It's like drama.
I can't wait to see this.
I like tea.
Hey Eagles, let's go find some Hyatts tea.
Tea in the Urban Dictionary is defined as the best kind of gossip. It is typically shared between friends, but it is also a bonding tool for all ages.
Let's go get the tea.
I heard Mr. Burson was an undercover cop.
Mr. Mitch has a giant YOLO tattoo on his back.
Did you know that Mrs. Rissmeyer has a pet spider that she walks on a leash? I couldn't believe it either.
My Hyatts tea is that I heard Mrs. Policino was once a bodybuilder.
You know that I was a state championship bowler in high school?
Miss Mantine is trying to steal my dog, Lulu. She even bought herself a mug with Lulu's picture on it.
Thanks for spilling the tea.
Now it's time for the 8-point clue.
Here is the 8-point clue. They shed their skin typically about once a week and usually eat it afterwards.
Again, they shed their skin typically about once a week and usually eat it afterwards.
For lunch today, let's go to...
Oh, wait, we got a special guest.
Oh, yeah.
Come here, Alex.
Come on up.
Watch the boys, blow it.
There you go, baby.
What's for lunch? Let's do this.
Okay, we have pasta with meat sauce.
Pasta with meat sauce.
Chicken sandwich.
Jet's pizza.
Pasta with marinara.
Green beans.
Prime main salad.
You ready?
Dancing?
Dance out.
What's it,
Colin?
Try one backwards, see what it does.
What? That looks weird.
Put one on backwards.
Okay, we're backwards.
Good job, ladies and Alex. That sounds like a great lunch.
Now let's get on to the next trivia clue.
Here's a 6-point clue for today's trivia.
The sound they make is called a croak or ribbit.
Again, the sound they make is called a croak or a ribbit.
So, for our daily student spotlight, we interviewed a 6th grader named Mohammed. Outside of school, he likes to play basketball and read. At Hyatts, he likes that you can fit in no matter how different you are. Here at Hyatts, he also likes the salad and the pizza crunchers. Right now, he is watching Jeopardy and Fortune Fire. Love Jeopardy, by the way. Thanks for being an awesome student.
Woo! Before we go on to the 4-point clue, we have a Spirit Day video by Balin's group. Let's check it out.
Hey Eagles, did you know tomorrow, the 17th, is Sweatpants Day?
Tomorrow's Sweatpants Day. I love sweatpants.
Me too. I love sweatpants. But you're not wearing sweats. It looks like you thought it was Hawaiian Day, Regan.
I did, but remember to get out and wear those sweats.
Wear your sweats. Bye.
That was a good video. I'm definitely wearing my sweatpants because tomorrow for 8th graders is going to be testing. That's going to be awesome.
For everybody.
A whole school as well, but also 8th grade.
All right. Here's the 4-point clue for today's trivia. They are amphibians. Again, they are amphibians.
Now to the lounge with sports.
Last night in the NHL, the Maple Leafs beat the Bruins 3-2.
The Hurricanes won against the Capitals 5-0.
And the Avalanche won against the Flames 6-2.
And finally, the Predators beat the Stars 3-2.
Also last night, the Blue Jackets are going to play the Tampa Bay Lightning at Nationwide Arena. Are you going to the game?
In the NBA, the 76ers beat the Nets 145-123.
And the Clippers barely beat the Warriors 135-131.
And lastly, in the MLB, the Cubs beat the Marlins 7-2, and the Dodgers won against the Reds 4-3.
And the Indians beat the Mariners 6-4.
That's all for sports. Before we go on to the Google fact of the day, we have the 2-point clue.
In some nursery rhymes, if you kiss one, it turns into a prince.
Again, in some nursery rhymes, if you kiss one, it turns into a prince.
Google fact of the day, what makes a cat purr?
One hypothesis backed by electromyographic studies is that cats produce the purring noise by using the vocal folds and or the muscles of the larynx to alternately dilate and constrict the glottis, rapidly causing air vibrations during inhalation and exhalation. Because I know you all understand.
Yeah, I don't think anyone understands it, except for those doctors back there.
Yeah.
We asked Sophie what her favorite app was, and she said Heyday.
Heyday is an app that you own your own farm and grow crops and sell them.
You can unlock animals, and for each level, you can unlock something new.
Now please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thanks again for playing trivia with us today. We really appreciate it.
Now let's go see what the answers were.
What is the answer?
So oh, what was the answer?
The answer was frogs.
Who eats frogs?
Ew.
I tried it.
It's good. It tastes like chicken.
Really good. Ew,
chocolate frogs?
It's like chicken wings.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah,
really
it tastes
good.
Like chicken. They're really good.
Didn't they eat it in like the Temple of Doom? You know that one scene where it's...
Oh, so you're saying you can't eat anything if it's a pet?
No.
Oh, okay.
I wouldn't think that.
All right, let's go over to the answers.
I mean, like, what if someone had a chicken as a pet?
No. Mr. Nicolosi got 4 points. Sloan got 6 points. Diekman got 10 points. Hollowball got 10 points. Rissmeyer got 4 points. Kern got 6 points. Meyer got 10 points. Juan got 4 points, and Mayer got 2 points.
So Miss Meyer,
got
15 points.
Yeah. Wait. Got 10 points.
She was the first. Yeah. No, well, yeah, Britton's a rookie back here with the new scoreboard. So Miss Meyer got the extra points.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Congratulations.
Woo!
All right, let's wrap up this ending, people. Nice and smooth.
Yay, this is my favorite part.
I'm Maya. And I'm Charlotte. As always, thanks for tuning in today for the 116th episode of Eagle News. We hope you really enjoyed today's broadcast.
My name.
Down to
go, go, go.
My name is Gavin. Have a terrific Tuesday.
And my name is Amelia. Make sure to get out those books and read.
Three, two, one. Ponyo, ponyo, fishy in the sea.
Tiny.
Hey, well, we won't see anybody till Monday because of testing.
Okay.
See you on
Bye.
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 Bye. Woo. Ponyo.